Hi guys, I'm just going to readjust this graver, and I thought you might be interested in this little fact. Can you see that? Right, this graver, I'll sharpen it as well, I'll do it all on camera. This graver was used using a Steve Lindsay 96 degree template, and the heel, you see that little white point at the end, that's what's referred to in graving terminology as the heel of the graver. If you're studying engraving, you may hear say they refer to make a short heel. Sometimes I tend to make quite a long heel because the tip of the graver might break, and to get rid of the chip I kind of make a longish heel, just kind of lazy or quickness, or you know, it's just something I do. But if you're kind of doing straight lines or you're doing things that aren't that detailed, it wouldn't really matter. And I think it does make it a little bit tougher. I don't know, I'm guessing really. Maybe it's just an excuse for being lazy, but just let me show you, although that it won't sound a lot. Right, so there's millimeters and there's the heel. Now if you make too short of a heel, then when you go to engrave, the graver really dives down quickly, and it's really hard to control, because the purpose of the heel, I'll kind of demonstrate on this ruler, the purpose of the heel on a graver is to give you the ability to, can you see how that position is there? So the heel is parallel with the surface of the metal, so that's how it would engrave. So if you imagine if you had no heel, then you would have to hold the graver almost flat to the surface of the metal to get it to travel along, because all it would do normally, if it was just a point, it would just dive down, it'd make a rough cut and all that. So you kind of need to experiment. I'd say when you're starting, don't worry about having a shorter heel, just have a nice one that you kind of, you're kind of probably going to overdo the sharpening when you start, but don't worry. Just kind of, so long as you're engraving, that's all that matters. If you're steering the graver left and right. So what I'm going to do now, so all I've got to do to make the heel shorter is just sharpen the face. And if you're new to engraving, all these terms sound confusing. Don't worry, there's a few terms that you need to learn, but there's not that many. But just for the fact that it's kind of something new, it can seem confusing, but there's not too much to learn in engraving. You're just something new, and just practice and it will become second nature. So that's how I was trying to do it so you could see it. Where is it? So I've just doing it on the camera like this so you can see it. So that just gets the graver at the correct distance for this template. And this is about a 2000 grit diamond stone, probably slightly less over the years, it's worn a bit. Right, yeah, it will need quite a bit. I could go to a rougher one, but I'll just keep going with this finer one rather than messing around with different stones. quite, it shows you a, and also when you do the hill, I mean, I won't do it now because I'll be back to square one, but this is how you would do the hill. But I'll pretend to do the hill. Normally all the hill takes is just 1, 2 and 1, 2, but when you start, like I said, you're going to give it some and think, oh yeah, I'm sharpening it, and then when you look at it, it'll be massive. So I well overdid it. Let me explain why, another reason why a shorter hill is good. I'll tell you what, I can explain it after I've sharpened. I meant to do it before, but I've started now, so I've got to finish. Oh, here we go. Right. So, in fact, I'm just going to just slightly touch up this. I am actually sharpening the hill, but can you see there? That's all I'm doing. If you chipped it, I'd probably do a bit more than that. But. Right, that seems to me just right. I mean, the smaller detail you're doing, like less, if you're doing tiny lettering, then you want to go to a shorter hill. I will engrave something. I'll explain in a minute why that's important. You can just see where that white line is, the hill, so you can just see the difference now if you compare it to the previous. And let's guess, oh, it's a fraction of a millimeter, so I'd say 1, 2, 3, say 5, it's a fifth of a millimeter. Oh, sorry, you're not on the right, you see millimeters, and I'd say the width of the hill would make up about 5 to go across a millimeter, maybe 6 even. Right, now I'll set it up and I'll do a little bit of engraving. Right, the reason why it's important to have a shorter hill is because I've been using it for that longer hill for a week or so, and what tends to happen is if you're following whatever you're doing, right, let's say you're following a template, the main thing is to get accuracy is where you initially place the graver. Oh, that's better. Yeah, right, it's where you initially so if you imagine, I could let's engrave this line slightly wrong, but it won't matter too much. But right, so the main thing for accuracy is where you initially place the graver. So let's place it slightly wrong. So I'll place it slightly outside. Right, I'm just past the line now. You can bring it back. But if you was doing something more important, you'd want to get spot on. But if you've got a really long hill, you'll find when you go to engrave, when you place graver there, you will have a mark. It's happened slightly even with a short hill, but because the grave is long, I use the analogy, it's like parking in a tight space. It's easier to park in with a smaller car than it is with a longer car. You know, you'll have to do more kind of manoeuvring to get in there, and you're going to probably bump into the next car. So that is the purpose of a shorter hill. Also, again, the car analogy, going around the corner. So if you imagine it was a longer hill, it would drag it would drag more and you'd make a more untidy cut. Again, it's like a, you can do a tighter turn in a small car than he can with a lorry. So exactly the same analogy. I think that's it. Yeah, I'll just do engrave this eye. We'll leave it there. Yeah, see, that's diving in. I kind of have to adjust my technique slightly because I noticed already that's diving in deeper than it would do if I had a longer heel. I think someone said that longer heels, you can engrave lines straighter with a longer heel, but if you're following a transfer, you should be able to. So when you change heels, you may have to adjust your technique. You get used to it after a few minutes. If you're carving, it probably doesn't matter, because carving, so if you're making a dimensional coin or whatever you're doing, you're going to do a lot of cleaning up anyway, so it probably doesn't matter so much. But if you're doing an engraving with shading, then a shorter heel probably does matter. Oh, so you can see there, I'm using that, so I'm placing the gravel where I want it. So that's, I use my, because I've got a transfer, I avoid touching the transfer. If you use the nail varnish technique, then it'll be harder wearing, so you can actually touch the engraving. But this is using chapstick, so if I touch it, the transfer will be gone, so I have to hover over the top, so it's a little bit more difficult. So what I do is I'm resting, you know, the better you can keep stable, so you kind of use these two fingers or that like that as a tripod. You've got these two fingers and your graver, but I also have this thumb. Why can't I see anything? Right, I have the thumb, so that's the thumb on my left hand, so I kind of use a combination to keep everything stable, and then kind of hover over where I want it, place the graver, and then one of my mad inventions, I'm thinking of have some kind of sling to kind of suspend my arm, so he's kind of held in the, he's held up because I've got a little bit of a problem with my wrist. Nothing to do, I don't think it's anything to do with actually engraving. I think I've damaged my wrist a couple of times, and I think there is some permanent something permanent there, but you wouldn't notice it if you didn't do engraving, but it's okay. It ain't gonna stop me. Oh, right, and see, I've got into a rhythm now, so don't rush it. If you think I'm going relatively fast, don't worry. The main purpose is for accuracy. Your speed will improve. Take as long as you need to take. The end result is what matters, not how quick you do it. Slightly. Leave it there. Once I start engraving, I don't want to stop. So, right, show you them cuts. Right, hope that helps, guys. Cheers, everybody. Bye.